So let them disperse. After that, we'll call the various groups to ask the questions. Let's put our hands together again for Hassan Ayariga.
Ever in my life. And I want to use this platform to acknowledge the presence of the chairman, Mr. Al-Haji Ramadan, members of parliament, Honorable Bayarga and Honorable Azong, former General Secretary, Mr. Kwama, Council of Elders, and many supporters of the PNC and executive. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, media friends and all invited guests, I am grateful to the IEA for giving me this platform and the opportunity to present myself and the vision of the new PNC to fellow Ghanaians. Our main theme shall be rehabilitation, redirection, youth empowerment, and economic growth in all sectors of the national economy. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time of the year when we are approaching an election, Ghanaians are more concerned about their future and that of this nation. We, as a nation, are worried about what is going to happen before, during, and after elections. It is our prayer that the Almighty God will see us throughout this election year peacefully and in harmony. It is our vision to bring peace for election 2012. We, the new PNC, have engaged in the preaching of politics of love, tolerance, fairness, transparency, so that democracy will be deepened. In that, political leaders and parties will have one common interest of educating and promoting peace and living together as one nation with one common goal of building a new Ghana. The PNC and Hassan Ayariga believe in the politics of togetherness rather than a divide and rule tactic. We are keen on bringing all political heads, opinion leaders, and society together for a new Ghana, where every Ghanaian talent and service is paramount in the transformation of ourselves and the nation. To repeat my clarion call to all, politics is not a tool for violence, and nobody can rule a bad nation. Elections must not be won at all costs. Permit me to use this platform to address a very important issue, that is the politics of insult, indecent language, abuse of personality in our political discourse, like the abuse of presidential candidates of political parties, and insults directed at the sitting president of Ghana, elected by Ghanaians. This kind of politics must stop, and this is not the kind of politics of Hassan Ayariga and the new PNC. I want to use this platform to thank all peace ambassadors and to encourage them to keep up the exercise of promoting peace in our upcoming general elections. We shall live in peace with ourselves and with our neighbors, and those who protect this peace shall never use violence without just cause. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, leadership is about taking responsibilities and solving fundamental problems of the future. No one can deny the fact that elections are about the quality of trust and the leadership style of the presidential candidate and his political party. These elections should be based on the comparison of the records of the various political parties and their candidates. Then we, in the PNC, have no problem with this because of the clean records and good governance of corruption-free administration of Dr. Hilal Imam from 1979 to 1981. Hassan Ayarga will bring to the table leadership of hard work, passionate patriotism, truth, honesty, and love. I will lead a system of government that will promote transparency in government businesses, the rule of law and justice, a listening ear, and be tolerant to dissenting views. Ghanaians have lost hope in our political system of governance because politicians say one thing and do another. We will rehabilitate the broken structures of our economy, reorientate the political mindset of our people, and mend the suspicions of mistrust that have existed between the political leadership and the good people of our dear country. Those who represent us in government shall render accountability to us to uphold our trust, and we shall render accountability to those who hold us in trust. Ladies and gentlemen, our administration will avoid the mistakes of partisanship in our country's political system. In short, the days where one is discriminated against the award of government contracts and appointment because you do not belong to a ruling party are over. Hassan Helga will be a father of all, a president of Ghana, who will serve the people of Ghana free and fair, irrespective of your political affiliations. The government of the PNC under Hassan Ayarga will make sure that we tap the talent of our growing youth and bring together experts from all political shades and opinions. Political parties will come and go, but Ghana, our dear country, will always remain Ghana. We should practice politics of love and respect for one another and not politics of hatred and violence. Ladies and gentlemen, good governance means honesty and transparency. The problem of underdevelopment in Africa can be traced to the problem of lack of transparency and selfless, dedicated leadership. In Ghana, planning is as serious a problem as implementation and monitoring. As the saying goes, he who fails to plan, plans to fail. And if you don't know where you are going, you will never know where you are. Ladies and gentlemen, I will bring on board a long-term national development plan for Ghana, which will be the next 20 to 30 years period. It will include a development policy document that contains the national vision. It will be a document that will focus on rehabilitation of various sectors of the economy, growth, and a new direction for our country. The significance of such a plan for the Ghanaian is that it will encourage long-term planning for all. It's going to be non-partisan development policy and will be drafted professional with theoretical facts on projections in all sectors of the economy in a long term. Individuals, particularly students, who therefore use the information in the LDTP has a guide in planning for skill acquisition. Also, business people will have relevant information for prudent decision-making with their businesses, and for investors, the LTBDP will provide the appropriate guide in investment decisions. PNC Administration will review the curricula of education from the basic to tertiary level, and that will include school syllabi, and will not only provide free compulsory free education, but also quality education for our people. We will put measures to improve teachers' willingness to impact knowledge to students, as well as allocate funding and create a mechanism to give up salary top-ups and accommodation facilities to teachers who work in deprived areas. This mechanism will include the component, evaluation component that will demonstrate whether or not the additional funds result in an improved teacher-student ratio in better examination results. My brothers and sisters, the PNC government will aim at equipping teachers with new improved ways of instruction to make teaching and learning more useful and meaningful and effective, and as well introduce entrepreneurial studies component in our school. We will build and create world-class universities with comprehensive technical and vocational institutions of education for our school dropouts, and also institute policies to make students become more creative and innovative in their studies. Our government will ensure that the tertiary institution assessing public funding offer priority programs for national development, and also reform the polytechnics to focus on technical and industry-based programs and not to compete with the universities for social science programs. We will expand the mandate of the Student Loan Trust Fund to cover private tertiary Ghanaian students, establish a competitive research and development fund for all tertiary institutions to carry out development-oriented research activities to develop and commercialize products. Ladies and gentlemen, we will promote specialization in information and communication technology in colleges of education and resource centers in each circuit center at the basic level. In collaboration with the Disability Council, all the people of Ghana shall have the right information, education, and the skill to improve their human and technical capabilities so that they will create jobs and also be capable of accessing gainful employment. We'll review the information and communication technology policy in education to mainstream disability issues and implement accordingly. We are still facing the key policy issue of lack of transparency and equity in the management and allocation of capitation grounds, and also equitable allocation of district assembly common funds. We will decentralize the management of the capitation grounds to district assembly, and also review the formula for allocating the district assembly's common funds to ensure deprived districts receive more as compared to blessed municipalities and metropolitans. And ensure that the full value of the capitation grant reaches all schools before the beginning of each term, as well set up a system to evaluate the impact of the capitation grant, Ghana School Freedom Program, free textbooks, exercise books, school uniforms for basic education access and quality. Brothers and sisters, we will pay more attention to technical and vocational training programs across the country to train and prepare more youth for the practical world. The intention is to help the create jobs for jobs and to de-emphasize the minds of people from concentrating on white-collar jobs rather than acting practically to create jobs out of their profession. This policy by the PNC will certainly help in producing more professionals rather than graduates who put pressure in central government for non-existing jobs. Has the youngest presidential candidate of this nation. My paramount interest is to empower the youth and women, as well as inspire them to take leadership as a tool of our economic and national development. I promise you, our government will initiate measures to ensure that the youth are involved in active participation in nation building. We will set up special retirement package for the aged, so that they will be willing to retire honorably without fear of not being cared for. Ladies and gentlemen, the youth form the majority of our unemployed, with an increasing number being those who have completed their secondary and third cycle formal education, and mostly those unskilled youth. My government will invest in the youth, both able and disabled. In our rehabilitation and redirection policy, we will endeavor to reorientate Ghanaians on our attitude to work and customer service, especially in the public sector. This will improve efficiency on overall customer experience. experience. Remember, effective leaders develop other leaders. Effective leaders take decisions and solve developmental problems. Whenever a nation has lack of quality, legitimate and just leaders, national deterioration occurs. Quality leadership is a key to prosperous and peaceful life and nation. When it comes to health, the PNC family believes that the most important source that a nation has is its population. Our society shall live in good health, both body and mind, and we shall deploy our diverse cultural heritage to protect sustainable living. We will work relentlessly to massively rehabilitate the decay in our hospital nationwide. All hospitals will be re-equipped with ultra-modern facilities and needed drugs to face the current and future challenges in the health delivery system, and build many more hospitals, polyclinics, healthcare centers, medical training schools, and number of nursing and paramedical training institutes nationwide. Our government will concentrate on the training of medical personnel, midwives, physician assistants, nurses, and many more young doctors. We will review the operation of our brainchild, National Health Insurance. With a view to strengthening and expanding it, and put up health maintenance organization to monitor and check the proper use of the scheme and advise government on the maintenance. Maternal and infant mortality will be tackled by coordinating existing programs and making them more efficient. Our trained midwives, especially those in the rural areas and communities, will be mandated to hold antenatal classes in their communities to educate expected mothers on the little lifestyle changes that can improve their well-being and that of their unborn babies. DNC and Hassan Ayerga will rehabilitate the existing one and build more mental hospitals and clinics to address the increasing problems of mental patients roaming in our streets. Treated mental patients will be reabsorbed into the society with assistance from the government in housing and skills training. A policy will be instituted where families will be educated to bring members who are mentally ill to hospitals for treatment and rehabilitation. All public buildings, public transport, public places will be designed with appropriate facilities to meet the needs of disabled persons. Ladies and gentlemen, agriculture still remains the mainstay of a nation's economy. The agricultural sector, given the right attention, has the fastest and highest potential for creating jobs, increase in income, eradication of poverty, boosting foreign exchange earnings, through export, and above all, the food security of our people. As part of our rehabilitation and redirection policy, the PNC administration will revisit Operation Feed Yourself program of the Achampong era to find out what went wrong and explore ways of repackaging it to make it a flagship in solving the food security needs of the nation. In furtherance of this objective, the PNC will acquire large tracts of farmland across the country and lease out to corporate and private commercial farmers with active government support in areas such as guarantee of funding, farm inputs, equipment, marketing of farm produce. It will be an integrated approach involving financial institutions, industries, input suppliers, farm machinery companies, government, and the farmers. Investors who wish to engage in commercial farming will be granted favorable terms and other incentives to turn our country into the food basket of the sub-region. Ladies and gentlemen, the PNC administration We rehabilitate abandoned silos and build new ones across the country. This will help in improving the food storage system in the country to reduce post-harvest losses. The intention is to provide food security for lean periods and in times of national disaster like crop failure due to bad weather conditions and crucial fire outbreaks and intense national flooding. More irrigation dams will be constructed across the country to enable all-year-round farming. Plant pools for mechanized agriculture for farmers will be set up in an effort to modernize and speed up agriculture revolution, to facilitate easy transportation of farm produce and people to urban areas. Feeder routes linking all food production areas will be given a priority. The railway network to aid in the transportation will be among the priority of the PNC administration. Ladies and gentlemen, our administration will aim at increasing cocoa production from the present 1 million metric tons to about 1.5 metric tons. Within the first 4 years of our stay in government, we shall achieve this by replanting all fallowed cocoa farms, mass distribution of fertilizers, introducing quarantine offices, moving cocoa depots away from borders to curtail smuggling, accessibility of chemicals by farmers, and effective measures to stop smuggling of cocoa. The shea nut industry will be given a boost to play a major role in the national economic development. We will establish large plantations of shea nut trees so that pickers will no longer depend on the wild shea nut trees only. A shea nut marketing board will be established to oversee development of the shea nut industry. We will expand and create more shea butter factories to create more jobs for youth and women in the northern part of Ghana and initiate policy to make it a viable source of income. Ladies and gentlemen, our government will review the existing fishing laws and block all loopholes that tend to put our fisher flock at a disadvantage. We shall also explore other ways of reviving and revamping the fishing industry. In this direction, our administration will tackle and solve the perennial problems of non-availability of pre-mixed fuel and other fishing inputs. We will work closely with the Ghana National Association of Fishermen and Farmers to explore ways of assembling outboard motors, manufacturing fish nets locally, and we shall make fishing a key model under the National Youth Employment Program to encourage the youth to engage in fish farming. Water is an essential part of life. The PNC government will expand portable water facilities throughout the country to make water readily available to the populace at all times. We shall guarantee adequate and regular supply of water to industries and communities. With regard to sanitation, the PNC administration will introduce an educational policy in our schools and communities, as well as we introduce the community sanitation inspectors in our local communities to monitor and collaborate with individual households to ensure that discipline and positive attitude towards maintaining a clean environment in public places and individual homes. We will put up different kinds of bins, advantage places across the country, and build more toilet facilities in our communities. We will use the 3 R's of sanitation, that is, recycle, reuse, and refill. And as well, initiate seminars to educate people on waste disposal, environmental pollution, and sanitation. We will also use the media to telecast education information on TV, radio, imprint media as a strategy to instill good habit of sanitation. We will put up landfill sites and recycle our waste. Ladies and gentlemen, we will change the town and country planning department into an authority in order to invest it more powers and extend its rules and mandate to execute challenges facing our housing infrastructure sector in the country, such as perennial floodings, sanitation, housing deficit, illegal structures, etc. The government will help intensify collaborative efforts between the town and planning authorities and the survey department to help solve challenges of our infrastructural needs. Our government, as part of its policy, will commit a percentage of its total annual budget into putting up more high-rise public buildings and well-planned communities to make housing accessible to all Ghanaians who cannot afford to build their home. This is to help reduce the current housing challenges facing the country by making good use of our available lands and to cushion public officials on their income. To do this, the PNC will bring together all stakeholders into the housing industry and tax them to meet government housing target within 4 years. The houses provided shall be given out to people on tenant-owner basis. In an effort to meet our energy requirement for industrialization and public consumption, the PNC-led administration will adopt a mixed approach, a strategy to build more hydroelectric dams to support existing ones and exploit the abundant wind along our coastal areas to generate more electricity and further exploit the sunshine in the country to generate additional electricity and also explore the possibility of using our nuclear reactor to generate further electricity. All this put together will make our country self-sufficient in energy production. Ladies and gentlemen, as part of our social policy and effort to fight for the Ghanaian interest, our leadership shall put into new mining reforms to regulate the entitlement process going to foreign mining companies and the inhabitants of our mining communities. The intention is to ensure a fair treatment to our local inhabitants of the mining areas. We shall achieve this by paying more attention to developing the mining communities through flagging back the proceeds from our mines. Again, we shall help to regulate the indigenous mining system, popularly called the Galamsey, by forming an association for them in order to monitor their activities as well as operations and make it legal and recognized by the state. Our government shall support them with mining equipment, capital, as well as protection from unfair external competition. Indeed, we need to review our mining laws to take care of environmental degradation problems. The foreign policy of the PNC government shall be in consonance with worldwide acceptable principles of public international law and diplomacy in a manner that will compromise the national interest or sovereignty of the Republic of Ghana in order to subordinate the dignity and independence of Ghana to foreign interests. All international agreements, contracts, treaties, conventions that will be executed on behalf or for Ghana shall be subjected to scrutiny and ratification by Parliament. My brothers and sisters, our government will introduce the three-shift system policy as we farm all year round, and our policy for rehabilitation and redirection. Ghanaians will now assess employment, different kinds of skill acquisition. As part of our long-term national development plan, children, women, disabled, jobless young men, and the less privileged in our society will access unemployment benefit for livelihood. Thereby reducing the level of poverty in our society. Ladies and gentlemen, I assure you that after the first 4 years of the PNC government under Hassan Ayariga, our dear nation will experience immense growth in wealth resulting from the honest, selfless, and dedication leadership that we will offer. We will save this nation. We will serve this nation with honesty and integrity to place this nation on such a pedestal that government after us will have no choice but to strive to at least maintain that benchmark. Fellow Ghanaians, in conclusion, I am confident that after listening to me tonight, you will agree that Hassan Ayariga is the right person to lead our nation at this time in its history. And I would like to use this opportunity to honor all past and present heroes who have helped in building this nation. A nation that fails to honor its heroes is not worth dying for. And to assure them that we will build on their immense contribution towards building this nation. And assure Ghanaians that we will serve with honesty, trust, love, and transparency. To thank every Ghanaian listening by radio or watching television and all invited guests, and hope that the Lord will take us through this election year peacefully and in harmony. Long live the PNC. Long live Ghana. Thank you, and thank you very, very much.